Attention to accessibility usually comes into play later on in the development cycle. A accessibility audit is conducted and a list of recommendations in how to improve the accessibility on the product is what usually comes out of these type of audits. By doing this, you are actually spending more money to improve your product when in actual fact, if you factored in accessibility at the very beginning, then you wouldn't be in this situation whatsoever. The best approach to an accessible user experience is to integrate it as part of the development process. The more accessible your site is, the more users that can use it, meaning it's great for business. The most common reason you will hear about not introducing accessibility is that only a small percentage of users who need accessible requirements. And that simply isn't true. Because did you know that 80% of disabilities are completely invisible? And 70% of digital content is not available to them. It's a large number of users that businesses are missing out on. Also, accessibility needs are situational, meaning as people move through different environments, their needs actually change. A great example of this is a new parent will pretty much do every single task one-handed. They'd be holding their infant in one hand and doing everything with the other hand. I personally have experienced this. I've just had a child. Believe me, I do everything these days one-handed because I'm always holding my little baby. Another great example is maybe somebody is using public transport and they've forgotten their headphones that day. They want to watch a cool video on YouTube, but they need the subtitles in order to understand what's going on. Again, that's accessible requirements for somebody who can usually hear quite clear on a day-to-day basis because they've forgotten their headphones that day. They can still enjoy the content without interrupting everyone else's experience on that train. Microsoft have great resources in order to explain inclusive design and accessibility a little bit more clearly. I'll leave that in the link in the description below. It's really easy to read where I've gained most of my knowledge. It's really, really simple to understand the difference in between situational and expectations. So yeah, check that out. What are the benefits of accessible design? The number one is you gain more users. As I mentioned earlier in this video, a recent study has been performed in the UK that 71% of users with a disability will instantly lose your site if they can't use the website freely. That's a massive loss of traffic and revenue and a complete loss in an untapped market. It also saves businesses money in the long run. Previously, if you embed accessibility into the development process, this will save you a lot of money within the future. The likelihood is you're going to need to do some redesign. You're also going to have to do some rewrite of code, and that can be a very time-consuming and costly process. One of the biggest benefits is inclusion. Because why wouldn't you want an accessible product? Like, seriously, think about it. Why? Accessible design really does minimize barriers. Features and content can be accessed by anyone's situational or permanent disability. Because if we don't account for inclusion, then we will create an alienating user experience. And that isn't good for the users or the company. Before we wrap up this video, I just want to stress adding an accessibility overlay isn't the answer. Now, if you don't know what I mean by an accessible overlay, then I'll put one up on screen now. And it usually consists of a little button in the bottom corner of the website. It's quite hard for these little overlays to pick up certain things in order to meet accessibility standards. And it's also counterproductive because if somebody is visually impaired, how do they find the little button in the bottom in the beginning? These are the things that you should be really thinking about. So adding in a little accessibility overlay is not the answer. Really embedding accessibility into your product from the beginning and throughout the development cycle is the way forward. If you have any questions, then please feel free to leave them in the comments below. If you like this video, then please consider subscribing to this channel and also hitting that like button because it really helps me. If you're also looking for a UX mentor, I do offer one-on-one mentoring sessions over on my Superpeer, and again, there's a link in the description below. I also have a newsletter, so if you want to sign up for that, again, there's a link in the description below, and the newsletter is sent out monthly. I send out loads of resources, sometimes discounts and things that I find interesting, sometimes my opinions on UX. So if that's something you're interested in, then sign up to my newsletter as well. And until next time, bye!